I'm Cortana.
It's been a little under 17 years since Cortana first appeared with the release of Halo Combat Evolved. In 2014, after four Halo games, Microsoft launched their virtual assistant under the same name on Windows Phone 8.1 as a response to the rising popularity of Siri and Google Now. This all-black design was different and modern relative to the other assistant. Cortana's voice was and still is done by Jen Taylor, the actress who voices the actual character in the Halo franchise. Although Cortana as a virtual assistant wasn't ever really part of the mainstream since it was only on Windows phones, for a short period of time, Cortana felt a lot more nuanced than the others in terms of features and scripted responses. You could set reminders, get useful and creative answers to a variety of questions, and could really customize your experience by choosing your interests. So Cortana was sort of like a mix between Siri's charm and Google Now's usefulness, which is honestly the perfect middle ground. However, at some point, it just felt like Microsoft stopped developing Cortana as much as they did in the beginning. Yeah, Cortana is still getting regular updates, it's on every single Windows 10 device, and now you can even get it on Android and iOS. But after 4 years, Cortana doesn't seem that much improved from what it was in the beginning. It still looks basically the same, it looks a little worse in my opinion, and while I've been using Cortana as my main assistant for a long time, it doesn't feel that personalized for me. Except for suggested tasks and some traffic and appointment notifications, most of these interest cards were manually selected, and there isn't that much of a dynamic adaptation to my activities. For example, I would expect my virtual assistant to automatically track my packages when I receive a notification in my email. However, this feature has been pretty inconsistent for me, and I often found myself manually inputting tracking codes into Cortana's notebook. It's also very slow. Many times I found myself spending a lot of time on this. So, in terms of basic assistant features, I feel like Cortana has fallen off compared to its competitors, especially compared to the likes of Google Assistant and Amazon Alexa. Though I should mention that Cortana has been getting a lot of improvements behind the scenes. There's a bunch of integrations with a lot of advanced services such as IFTTT and a lot of connected home stuff including Nest, Hue, and SmartThings. So you can take advantage of Cortana even more if you go really in depth with all these integrations. Microsoft is also looking to make Cortana smarter by implementing machine learning and other general AI things throughout the shell of Windows 10 and future versions such as Redstone 5 and 6. This means that Cortana will theoretically become much more personal to users as it adapts to their usage on our Windows machines. But here's the thing, even though Cortana is essentially on more devices than any other assistant out there because it's also the default search function for all Windows 10 devices, it's still only officially supported in just 13 countries. Some people theorize that this is due to Cortana being powered by Bing, and sadly, I do use Bing. I think it's good enough for most things, but that's probably because I'm in the US. It's quite clear that Bing is very limited in most other countries, so this is probably the most plausible reason that Microsoft hasn't expanded into more countries and languages. The most disappointing thing about Cortana for me is that Microsoft just hasn't pushed it enough. Like how Apple didn't do much with Siri after its launch, Microsoft sort of just left Cortana in the dust as well. Cortana launched at a time when Halo was still one of the trendiest games out there, and instead of riding that wave, it felt like they kind of just forgot about it. During these last few years, we saw a whole wave of virtual assistants come out and ride to the top. Google released a bunch of Google Home products, while Amazon released their popular Echo and other Alexa devices. These smart speakers were crazy successful in terms of sales and word of mouth. It definitely took over the internet for a period of time. Right now, there are basically only three types of native Cortana speakers you can buy: the Harman Kardon Invoke, a Windows 10 PC, or an Xbox with Kinect. I have a gut feeling that no one really uses Cortana on Windows other than to set up their new computer, and it looks like Microsoft is slowly getting rid of Kinect on Xbox, which is also getting rid of the system's microphone, which is then getting rid of access to a lot of Cortana's features. The Harman Kardon Invoke looks really nice though, especially considering the huge price drop. I think I'm gonna buy that soon to try it out. I'll let you guys know how it goes. Basically, I'm just disappointed how Microsoft doesn't seem to want to compete in this space head on. I mean, they're one of the biggest companies in the world and the people there are definitely much smarter than me, but still, it'd be nice to see more Cortana devices out there. Since Cortana can be on so many different devices, there's gotta be a decent number of people like me using it and wanting to use it as well and as easily as the other assistants out there. Alright, so I know I've been mostly negative in this video, but I do think Microsoft is starting to try a little more in this space. They recently announced that they bought Semantic Machines, a California-based company developing conversational AI, to improve Cortana and make its interactions with you much more natural and personal. Microsoft also announced a partnership with Amazon to integrate Alexa into Cortana. It looks like Cortana and Alexa will have access to each other's databases depending on the task. They showed this off a bit at Build, but I still don't get how it will work completely. We'll probably find out more about this crossover later this year. Just like what they've been doing with mobile devices, I think Microsoft is just done playing catch up to markets where they have losing battles. I mean, it's been working out pretty well for them considering Microsoft recently overtook Alphabet as the third most valuable company in the world, with Azure doing amazing and the enterprise sector still bowing down to them. But as a consumer who has been loving their consumer products, including Windows, Surface, and Xbox, it sort of sucks when the part that links this ecosystem together isn't good as it should be. I am optimistic though. I think Microsoft does realize how important virtual assistants will be in the beginnings of this AI race. After Google showed off Google Assistant's upcoming feature called Duplex, which basically allows a human-like AI to do boring tasks for you, like scheduling a haircut or a restaurant reservation, when I saw this being demonstrated, I was blown away, and I definitely wasn't the only one. In a recent Mashable podcast, a Microsoft corporate VP of Cortana, Javier Soltero, said that while he was really impressed with Duplex, Microsoft was focusing more on enabling Cortana to do more things yourself, like a tool. That might not sound as fun as a consumer-facing assistant like Google Assistant and Alexa, but I think it's an interesting spin in this race, and I'd like to see what that will look like as time goes on. Anyways, sorry I've been kinda everywhere in this video, that's basically how I feel about where Cortana is at this point. I'm slightly disappointed in where it's at right now, especially on the consumer front, but I'm hopeful for what Microsoft's gonna do with it in the future. Alright, that's gonna do it for this video, thanks for watching, and if you like videos about Microsoft or any interesting tech, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And in the comments down below, let me know what you guys think of Cortana or even just the state of virtual assistants at this point. You can kind of go anywhere in this topic, so feel free to shoot any thoughts. I'd love to get some conversations going. Alright, see you guys in the next one.